Despite opposition, Governor Lamont is still pushing ahead with his transportation plan, which includes tolls.
He's now asking lawmakers to take up transportation during a special session the week of December 16th. Our chief Capitol reporter, Susan Raff, has reaction.
Governor Lamont may want this to happen, but there are other things slated for the special session. And there are people who want more details, especially when it comes to tolls.
I said, let's start with trucks only. You don't want cars and trucks. I salute the Democrats from the House. They've come forward with a plan. It raises over $280 million. This is real money that we can do.
This was last week after Governor Lamont met with Democrats and Republicans. Now he's ready for a vote. In a letter to legislative leaders, Lamont wants lawmakers to take up transportation and tolls in a special session. He says he understands this is a difficult and expedited time frame, but these are important issues which require resolution before year end. Tolls are a tough sell.
The taxation that already is imposed on Connecticut residents and the fact that the government has not been terribly responsible with my money.
And what about the speaker's claim that trucks do 80% of the damage?
It's a made-up number. Let's stick to facts and try to get our finances in order.
Taking up tolls in a special session will be challenging. Transportation would be added to a vote on bonding for cities and towns, along with a hospital settlement and an agreement on wages for tip restaurant workers. A big complaint? There are no spreadsheets, no paperwork.
I think it's very difficult for Republicans to support a toll plan, given the fact that there's a no toll plan on the table.
We don't have an actual bill as of yet. The bill has to be signed off on by the speaker and by me. It has to be fully drafted.
The Senate president says taking up tolls in a special session isn't necessarily unrealistic, but calls it ambitiously optimistic, saying January is more likely. In Hartford, Susan Raff, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.